Hi friends, doing well, staying safe and staying healthy. I am Dr. Anchal C. Kakkar. For all those who don't know, I'm a PhD in Vastu Shastra and Feng Shui. So yes, today I'm here to discuss about Vastu tips for home and offices. So today we are going to talk about what is Vastu. I'm going to make it very simple for you so that it's not a myth actually. People believe, you know, it's a myth. People believe that it's some ancient science. It's not true, but it is actually very true, because if you link properly all the things in your home or in your offices, I mean commercially and residentially, according to Vastu Shastra, you see a very positive and a very harmonious and a prosperous change in your life and your family life. So yes, Vastu is basically linking, making a balance of man and the nature, and by that I mean linking tan and man. By that I mean again body and soul of a man with the elements of nature, which is very important, because as we also know that our body is made of five elements. So balancing out that within the house and commercially, so that we see a very positive change in our lives, we follow Vastu. Vastu is basically combined of three major things, that is magnetic force, gravitational force and solar energies. We all know that solar energies are basically the sun rays. The sun rises from east, we all know that, right? So balancing these energies at your home or commercially, so that things are meant to happen in a good and a positive way. The gravitational force and the magnetic force. The magnetic force plays a golden rule in Vastu Shastra, because we all know that north attracts south and south attracts north. So opposites do attract. It's everywhere, right? And then it's the gravitational force. So these three are the basic and the main rules in Vastu Shastra. And the four cardinal directions in Vastu Shastra are considered to be north, south, east and west. As we all know, we have these four directions, right? The north representing our mother. We have to make sure that the north of a house is very open, so that our maternal family stays safe and stays healthy. So these are very small things, you know, if we consider them, we will see drastic changes at our home. The south direction considering the leader of the family, it's supposed to be stable, so that to get financial stability in your family. That is very important, that your south direction is placed very properly in your home or commercially. Then is your east direction, from where the sun rises. So we also have to make sure that the east direction is proper, so that there is no obstruction in east direction. If there is obstruction in east direction, it brings a lot of problems in your health. So to make sure that there are no health issues, we make sure that east direction is properly well lit and has a lot of space. We cannot make it very cluttered. We have to keep it very easy. And then it's our west direction, which makes us famous in life, which brings us stability in our life, which gets us good health, name and fame. So definitely we also want our west direction to be perfect. So Vastu is basically just an ancient science which was developed many years ago, many centuries ago, I would say, which is considered to be Lord Shiva's tears. So yes, Vastu is considered to be Lord Shiva's tears, when the tears which fell from his eyes, which was made into Vastu Purush. And we all, whenever we do a Griha Pravesh, or whenever there is some new opening, we all do a Vastu Puja, so that there is no Vastu Dosh around us. I'm sure a lot of people know that, and especially the Asians know this about this science very well, and I'm sure they even follow it. If you follow it properly, you see a drastic change. I'm going to give you very small tips today, so that you can, if you see that small changes in your home, it will be very good. For example, the toilets. So make sure that the toilets are not in north, northeast or east. Except these directions, your toilet can be anywhere. The toilet should never be facing the main entrance. If it's facing the main entrance of your house, or any washroom is facing the main entrance of your house, make sure you put a mirror outside your house, so that all the negative energies are reflected inside the mirror and it does not carry forward into your house. And yes, southeast. Let's talk about southeast direction, which should be very, very well lit and built up very nicely, because usually we always say that kitchen should be in southeast. That's okay. If your kitchen is not able to be in southeast, make sure your southeast direction has a lot of red color in it, has a lot of bright shades in it, because it's the main Agni Kon. So don't put any water near there. If you put water near there, you will face health issues, a lot of health issues you're going to face. Southwest direction is also for the stability of the head of the family. So it's very important for southwest direction also be too stable. So you can plant big trees. I mean, if you can have a good lawn in southwest, you can even put pictures, a good mountain pictures in southwest, because all the pictures, if you put according to directions, that'll be really good for your house. Like I'm sure we all love different new paintings. So if you put those paintings accordingly to Vastu Shastra, you're going to really see the difference in your house. One thing I will always say, what should not be there according to Vastu, because according to Vastu, what should be there, we have a lot of knowledge about it, and you know, people usually Google it to see. But I always say that half knowledge is always misleading. So get the perfect good knowledge from a proper professional and then proceed further for everything. What should not be there according to Vastu is that there should be no cracked mirrors at your place. There should be no broken mirrors. There should be no leaking taps at all. Make sure there are no leaking taps. There should be, when you open the door, there should be no noise in the doors or your windows. So these small things, if you make sure that they are not there, you will see very good changes in your home. And yes, make sure your house is well lit. It's very important your house is well lit. And no clutter. By clutter, I mean no unnecessary furniture also should be in your house. If you make it more clutter, like a lot of furniture, people have a habit of putting a lot of antiques, a lot of furniture in the house. What happens? You're just cluttering your mind. Your home is representing your body, your mind. Your office is representing your body, your mind. So make sure your soul, your mind, and your body is very clutter-free so that you can make the right decisions and you're very easygoing in life. Vastu is very simple. It does not involve any difficult things. It's very simple. If you put do these kind of small remedies, you will see drastic changes. For example, the Brahmasthan of your house, that's the center of your house, should be always empty. There should be nothing on the Brahmasthan. Brahmasthan is basically, how do you measure it? You take the length and the breadth of your house, that's the height and the width of your house, and then you see the whatever the center point, you take it out, and that's your Brahmasthan. Make sure that Brahmasthan has no furniture over it and nothing heavy object over it. You can obviously place few small flowers or plants or a small temple over there, but no heavy things at all. Make sure it should be just clutter free completely, or it should have nothing on it. And yes, one more thing, there should be no obstruction, like electric pole or, you know, a temple, anything, or a tree in front of your main door, because that does create a lot of obstructions in your life. Keep open space in the northeast. For example, you can even have a swimming pool, you can even have a lawn, you can even have a small garden or any, you know, a small anything, or you can even have aquarium. But I always say that, you know, aquariums are never good. Why? Because you are just blocking. People ask me, ma'am, hum aquarium rakhe, should we keep aquarium? I always say, you know, aquariums are not good. Instead that, keep money fountains. Keep fountains which are completely flowing, because north is your money direction, it's the Kuber direction. So make sure that the money is completely flowing. If the water keeps flowing all the time, the money also keeps coming and keeps going, and you save money as well if your south direction is stable. But yes, it's very important not to keep aquariums. Why? Because you just, you know, for example, everybody likes freedom. That's what I believe and that's what I follow. So everybody wants freedom in their life. You're just putting those fishes in a small aquarium, and just, you know, putting them inside and telling them, no, you have to stay here. No, I always say, don't put aquariums. Let them just release them. Don't make them there. Don't cage them. Don't cage any animal. I always say it's very bad according to Vastu, and personal life, it really affects. So yes, and your prayer rooms, if possible, you can meditate facing east direction. It's the best form of meditation. If you can do facing east direction, that'll be very good if you do that. Make sure the elders, if you put, you know, if you hang pictures of your elders, it should be facing southwest direction. Or you can even put it on southwest wall, because that brings in stability in your house. That's very important. your elders blessing should always be there with you. So put it in a direction which is very stable. So south's direction is the most stable one. You can even put hill paintings out there. You can even put a large tree paintings. You can even put greenery out there. That'll be really good. And yes, if possible, put an idol of Lord Ganesha at the front door of your house and one idol at the last wall of your house, so that your house is completely protected. Or if not Lord Ganesha, whoever god you believe in. I always say that don't double the idols, that's very bad, but I always believe putting in Lord Ganesha at the front of your house and at the last wall of house for ultimate protection of your house. So basically, you know, these directions we should remember. It's very easy to put things because, you know, if you follow what the direction means, because these four directions are completely related to elements. So what are these elements? That's water, fire, earth, space. So these elements, you know, these elements rule our directions. I mean, these elements rule our directions. So if we place them properly, according, adjacent with the direction and elements, should be adjacent and coordinated with each other, you see a drastic change, trust me. And you see very, very positive things happening in your house and in your life. So if you follow these small tips, I'm going to keep coming and keep giving you a lot of tips. And yes, I get also a lot of questions on the staircase of the house, what should we put? So yes, on the staircase of the house, you can put in small, you just put small plants out there. That'll be really good. You can even hang small mirrors out there. But yes, before I tell you about mirrors, never hang mirrors facing north or facing east direction. The mirror should not face those directions. The mirror can be on those walls. So yes, not facing. If you're unmarried, if you're planning to, you know, get your daughter married, then shift her room in northeast direction. That would be very good. So you know, you will see that, you know, your daughter will, everything will happen very easily, and you know, there will be no obstructions in marriage. The master bedroom of your family, of your as a couple, should always be in southwest direction. It brings in stability, it brings in easiness in your relationship, and you will listen to your partner and consider their advice. So make sure that your master bedroom is in the southwest direction. You can even put, whenever you put in anything, you know, any idols or probably swans or probably any birds, anything, put them in couples. So don't put them in, you know, single. Put them as a pair in the master bedroom. That's really important because it's a master bedroom of a couple. So yes, make sure you do that. And yes, even instead of doing this, you can also, if you're, you know, you're planning a child or you're on your way of family planning, then shift your room to northwest. And trust me, you will see that things will go easy for you for the family planning. So these are very few tips which I'm giving you, and these are very basic tips which I really want that, you know, if you guys follow, you will see good changes. For example, even in southeast direction, if you are in southeast direction, you can make sure that the southeast direction of your house is of bright, made of bright colors. It has red colors. You can put in red roses over there because southeast direction is, you know, it's the fame direction. So we want that our fame should just go like a fragrance. So make sure that the smell of that fame and the name should be there. So make your southeast direction very bright with a lot of bright shades. Put in good flowers there and good scents there, so that your name also should prosper in life and should just move in your life just like a fragrance. It should go without any obstructions, right? One thing, guys, make sure that, you know, you do not go for any L or C shaped plots. Avoid going for L or C shaped plots completely. Go for a regular shaped plot, rectangular or a square shape. Those who are planning to buy a house, I'm sure if you keep this in mind, you will see a lot of positive change as well. And yes, make sure that you do not never sleep under or over beam, or, you know, there should be no overhead beams under you whenever you're studying or you're working or you're sleeping. It just makes a lot of pressure in your head, and you know, you feel very heavy with things. So I'm sure all of you don't want to feel heavy, right? And yes, as I just told, that there should be no violent pictures, no battle scene pictures in your home. This is your home. There should be no battle scene pictures at all. So yes, you can even put Lord Lakshmi picture in north direction because it's considered to be the money direction. That would be very good for you. You can even put a Kuber Yantra in north direction. So these are very small tips. If you follow, you will really see positive changes. I'm repeating this again and again because I really want, you know, if just follow these small tips and see how positive changes come in your life. And yes, one more thing, the mirrors, whenever you place mirrors, make sure your mirrors are never broken. You know, there should be not even a single broken area in your mirror, because if it's there, remove it then and there. Don't fix it. Don't, you know, just want them that they should get okay. Just throw them out of your house then and there, because broken things are always bad. And avoid crowding, make it very spacious. So avoid crowding of things. Make your entrance very well lit and very beautiful, because your entrance represents you. So whenever we want a, whenever we enter somebody's house as a guest, we always see the entrance. Hum jab bhi ghar de entrance dekhte hain, we see ha iska ghar bahut acha hoga, ye kitne acche se rehta hai. So kehte hai na, first impression is the last impression. So aapka first impression entrance will make. So make sure your entrance is very well lit, has a beautiful, had beautiful things over around your entrance. You can even put a small water bowl over there, and on that you can put flowers over there. That's very good. Put good paintings, put something very attractive. Your entrance should be very attractive. So these are very few tips. If you follow them, you will see drastic changes. And yes, I always say avoid taking house which is facing southwest direction. So avoid houses which are facing southwest direction. There are remedies for solving all of these problems. And yes, so please take full knowledge before doing any remedy. So as I say, half knowledge is always injurious. So take full knowledge before doing any remedies. And I will be back again with more tips for commercially and more tips for residential purposes as well. So keep following these tips, and if you really like this video, please just, you know, write down how these tips brought in changes in your life. As I say, it's very important to maintain a balance between and harmony between nature and your body and soul. So do that and trust me, you will see all the changes. So let me know how you do these changes and how do you follow them. Thank you so much for watching me, and take care. God bless.